Hi everybody, this is Friday, the 18th of December 2020, and this is our weekly video in English. I am Thekla Petridou, a psychologist, an author and a YouTuber, and every Friday I upload a video in English on my YouTube channel, that is mainly Greek channel, for the friends who live abroad and ask me to make some videos in English. Today's subject is personal. It's about what life has taught me in 2020. I made the same video in Greek earlier this morning about the Greek viewers of our channel. 2020 has been a rather difficult year, I think for everybody in the world, not just for me. This year, we came to terms with our mortality, with the fact that we do not actually have control over our lives, that sudden events, unprogrammed events, sudden changes in the world balance, like a world pandemic, can bring upside down in our lives. Make some coffee and let's talk about it. 2020 did not start well for me. I'm supposed not to be looking at coincidences or being a psychologist and all, not to see signs, but New Year's Eve, it was not pleasant. I did not have a good time. And I remember myself on New Year's Day to wake up late and living and feeling somewhat sad. I was in a marriage, my second marriage, which the relationship started in late 2016, the marriage happened in 2018, and I was for the second holidays alone with my then husband and without my children, because my children are adults, and they have their own lives, so they were not with us. I remember waking up in the morning, in the afternoon of New Year's, and I was thinking that it is such a good thing that signs are not really important, because if the whole 2020 would be like the New Year's Day, oh man, it would be bad. And it was bad. And I don't think that 2020 was bad because I had a bad New Year's Eve. It was bad because it's been one of the most difficult years I remember in my life, and I'm 45 years old. When the pandemic came to its coronation around the mid-March, I was unprepared for what was to come. I was in the middle of my book tour, my latest book tour. My latest book had come out, had been published on 24th of October 2019, and I was still touring throughout Greece, Cyprus, and I was even planning on visiting the UK in time, and everything shut down. And I had to stay at home and live in the same house with my then husband and my son, who came to Cyprus to spend the lockdown with us. My son is 23 years old. He has finished his master's degree this summer, and he didn't have any lessons to attend to in the UK where he had his master's. So he said, I will come and stay with you, guaranteeing with you. So he came, he guaranteed with us. The family dynamics changed in a way that reminded me of myself, and reminded me of who I am and how I view life. Because for those of you who don't know me, because usually the videos in English are viewed only by people who watch my videos in Greek, so they know a lot about me, because I'm all about self-disclosure. I'm a psychologist, I'm 45 years old, as I said earlier. I got married for the first time when I was still a student. I had my son as soon as I had my bachelor's. I had my daughter when I was 25 years old. And at the age of 26, I divorced with my first husband and I raised my kids by my own, with some help of their father, of course, but because he lived abroad, we didn't do the communal parenting, which I would love to do. I would love to be in a position to have shared custody and shared parenting. So most of the time the children were with me and we had our own rules in the house, and I tried to raise my children according to my belief system. I write all about it in my book, Happy Mom, Happy Children, which is not translated to English yet, but I hope that it will be translated maybe this year or the year after that. And I write all about my struggles to realize what would be better for my children, what would be better for me, to raise children in a society that is so diverse, and trying to merge my traditional upbringing with my psychology knowledge, and of course with my new lessons that I got from life each year. I'm 45 years old. I've studied most of my life, but the most important lessons of all came from life itself, and not from the university, not from any course I studied or any course I taught, because I also teach courses now. Anyway, and when my son was there with us, the family dynamics changed, and I could see clearly that I had lost my path. And I'm not blaming anybody else but myself, because what we do to ourselves, we do ourselves. Our brain has complicated ways to deal with difficulties. One of the most major difficulties adult people have, and even children also and teenagers have, is the fear of being alone, the fear of left out. So sometimes we compromise and we get ourselves into a relationship that is not suitable for us, that it's not a good relationship itself, because the word relationship in Greek, it's female, that's why I said herself, which is not a suitable relationship itself, it's not a healthy relationship for any of the parties involved. And we tick that box that, okay, my need for partnership and my need for romance and my need for companionship is covered, so I go to other boxes, and now I work hard, now I work out, now I try to deal with other difficulties, and I have solved that problem. No, my friend, you haven't solved that problem if you just ticked the box and if you compromised with something that was not as good as you have imagined you deserve. I really do believe that we should dare to dream about ourselves, to have the best of everything, the best quality of life, and especially the best spiritual quality of life. I'm not so materialistic. I can understand people who are materialistic, because this is a materialistic society. We live in capitalism, and it's all about material gains and belongings around us. But I choose, and I chose all my life, to focus on spiritual goods, on academic goods, and on inside goods and not outside. Of course, we all need a house to stay in. We need a roof above our heads. We need to have the money to feed ourselves, to take our medical care, and even to buy our coffee or pay for the electricity and the internet so that I'm able to talk to you and you're able to see me. But above that, luxurious life has never been my goal. Whereas other people sees, and I appreciate it, and I accept it. Not everybody should be thinking the same way, and we need all kind of people in our lives. I mean, in order for this world to go forward, we need all kind of fighters. Even people who fight for material gains, they help the society to go on. Anyway, after like 7 weeks of quarantine, my marriage finished on the day of my 45th birthday. I was born on the 4th of May 1975, and the 4th of May 2020, it was my 45th birthday. And on the awakening of my 45th birthday, I realized my marriage finished. I wasn't the one who took the decision, but in retrospect, I should have taken that decision years ago. But it's okay. This is life. Life happens. Shit happens. And I had to deal with it. Having to deal with a second divorce in the age of 45 and having lived for most of your life as a single parent, it's somewhat difficult. And it's not difficult practically, because all my life I've been used to fighting and trying for two people, especially when I was parenting my children, that their father was not in the picture in the same country, he lives abroad. So I had to be there twice as much as if other mothers have that the father is in the picture. I wasn't afraid of the practical parts. I know how to build a house and how to bring a house down. I know how to fix everything in a house. I know how to work hard. I know how to pursue my well-being and my family's well-being. But the difficult thing was to admit to myself that I made a mistake to marry for the second time, that I was not being truthful to myself and my values, and that I allowed myself to sleep in a deep dream and think and believe that I was happy, whereas I was not. I have forgotten myself. And myself, my soul and my body reacted. In 2017, when I was like 9-10 months into that relationship, I had signs in my body and my skin especially of an autoimmune disease, which is called Lehen planus. And my doctors told me that this is due to some internal struggle, this is due to stress, this has psychological factors contributing to it. I chose, subconsciously I guess, not to see in the bigger picture, not to see the forest. I saw one tree. I said, oh, my problem is this one. Some toxic people in my life, not in my house, in my social circle. I didn't listen to the bells telling me that, wake up, you forgot your soul, yourself, you lost your road in life. And then I had to be diagnosed with diabetes and thyroid disease. I had to start living differently. I stopped eating anything sweet, anything with gluten. I changed my diet. I started exercising regularly. And my autoimmune disease gone. It was gone. So I said, that's it. The problem was diabetes, underlying diabetes. The problem was the thyroid disease. Now that I have calculated everything and I ticked my boxes again, healthy eating, hiking, walking, shedding extra kilos. So I'm okay. But I wasn't okay. So the pandemic came, the lockdown came, and it taught me a valuable lesson. You should never forget yourself. You should never forget who you really are and what you really wish for yourself and what are your dreams in life. What is your dream about yourself? How what's your vision? How have you visioned yourself at this age that you are now, when you are 20 years old, 15 years old, 10 years old? All my life, I have been visioning myself like a strong woman, an independent woman, a free woman, a woman who is able to take control of herself, control of her life, and who is able to give to other people the things she wants to get from life. This has been my life's vision. And now at this age of 45, I am able, finally, to go through with it. For those who don't know me well, I used to host a daily TV show on Cyprus television for 2 years. I stopped, I didn't sign for the third year. I didn't renew my contract, even though I was accepted an offer to. I decided on 9th of August 2019 to withdraw my activity on YouTube, because I really do believe that the internet and YouTube at this time is the platform of today and tomorrow and not national television. I decided to leave my actual office. I had an actual office of a psychologist for 20 years. from late 1997 till late 2017. I hold a virtual office sometimes. Sometimes I can do some Skype sessions, but most of the time I do not see clients. And I decided to dedicate myself into producing psychoeducational videos such as this on YouTube and writing books. And for me, this is a worthy way of living life. This is a way to give back to the universe of what I have gotten, because I have been blessed enough to be born in a spiritual family. My father is a Greek Orthodox priest and a theologist, and my mother is an ancient and modern Greek language teacher. They are both spiritual people. They are both very religious. I am not yet anymore, but I was brought up in a house that we had lots and lots of libraries, libraries in every wall, not a television set. The first time a TV set entered our home was when I was like 12 years old. I have read thousands of books, literary. I've read thousands of books. I remember myself being 6 years old and reading very heavy duty books, which I didn't understand completely. And I had to ask my father, what does this word mean and what this is? And I was blessed to be born and shaped in a family that had discipline, that had vision and spirituality. Of course, growing up in this family has had some side effects. The reason, one of those was that my dad, when I was young, he used to beat me regularly once a month. I write all about this on my book, Happy Mom, Happy Children, and also on my book, Psychological Warfare. Again, I say my books are not translated to English yet, but I have a vision for them to be translated, so they will be. And I had also some traumatic experiences growing up, but that's life. You cannot get everything. You get parts, good parts and bad parts. The good parts of my upbringing, I'm very grateful about. And when I went to study in Thessaloniki, Greece, I've met some very important spiritual people who used to be my mentors and used to inspire me in life. And later on, throughout life, I was given the opportunity to read books, to attend lectures, to work with people with high spiritual values, and I feel I've been blessed. And I feel that I have this responsibility, and this will make me feel happier about myself and will make me feel more content to give back a little something of what I got. For people who don't have access to books, they don't have access to therapy, because another blessing in my life was that I am on therapy for at least 15 years now, with some breaks. I love therapy, mostly because I need it, and secondly because I'm a therapist myself and I feel that therapists should continually be on therapy. I was also blessed to have an excellent friend in my life. My best friend is Dr. Aristoniki Theodosiou. You know her. Those of you who watch our channel in Greek, you know Aristoniki. She's my best friend. She's a wonderful woman. She's an academic. She has, I don't know how many master degrees, a doctoral degree. Now she's doing her postdoc, a researcher, a writer, an author as well. She also publishes scientific work. She's published in scientific magazines. I am not. I'm not an academic. I'm a first respondent psychologist, I would say. Aristoniki has enriched my life. She has brought me into new actualizations about life. She has been my inspiration since 2011 that I met her. I've also been blessed to have two beautiful children inside out, especially inside. My son and my daughter are the better versions of me, and they are more progressed than me, and they teach me daily with their example and their logic and their emotions how life can be better and more enjoyed. And I have been blessed to have to host this channel on YouTube since 2011, but mostly the last 4 years to have daily contact with you. my subscribers that I came to feel like my extended family, my spiritual family. So 2020 gave me a very hard slap. Told me, wake up, you haven't figured life out yet. No. You just made a pause. You made a long pause, long enough to give you 20 additional kilos. Right now, I've shed 11 of those 20 additional kilos last 4 years gave me, and I'm moving on. I'm not dieting. I just stopped eating my feelings. And I started hiking again, walking, which is my therapeutic exercise. I think that psychotherapy and walking, hiking, can give me my calmness, my serenity. It can give me myself back. It's been hard the last 7 months. It's been hard to be single again after all, after 4 years of thinking of yourself as somebody who doesn't have this problem of being single or being alone or being in a house by herself. I have given myself the opportunity to go away. I've left Cyprus. On 7th of September 2020, I came for holidays to this new country. I haven't revealed my location yet, so I'm not saying yet. I did that without realizing. Subconsciously, I wanted to move from Cyprus ever since I remember myself. I tried hard to move from Cyprus and stay, for example, in Thessaloniki in 1997 when my son was born. But because I wasn't alone and I wasn't by myself, I couldn't take that decision. In 1998, I tried to emigrate with my family in the US because I had a scholarship for postgraduate studies in Boston. But my son and my ex-husband could not get a visa for the US, so I decided to stay with my child that was breastfeeding instead of leaving my family behind and going by myself in the US. In 1999, I tried to stay in Manchester and emigrate there because we were in Manchester for postgrad studies, but it was not up to me, so I couldn't make it. In year 2000, I tried to emigrate with my family in Australia, but again, it was not up to me. And in 2001, when I divorced my first husband, my children had already rooted in Cyprus. So I felt that it was not a responsible thing of me to do, to take them alone without their father and go in a third country, a country that is not my country, not their father's country. So my plans for emigrating stopped in 2001. And finally, in 2020, 19 years afterwards, I am able to do that. My children are adults. My son has finished his studies. He's working now. My daughter, she's studying abroad. She's getting ready for her master's degree to be in another European country. Now she's in the UK. So I don't have any ties to Cyprus. I don't have a cat. I don't have a dog. My parents are young and healthy. And I decided to come for holidays in this country, which is a neutral country. I didn't have anything to do before. I found an excuse. We can always find an excuse in ourselves inside ourselves when we want to do something. I found an excuse for myself to come here. I came even though I knew that there was a big risk due to coronavirus restrictions on travel that I might get stuck here. I got myself stuck here and I enjoyed it. I've been here for 3 months and a half now. The main reason I came here and I stayed here is myself. And the fact that I want to see myself away from everything and everybody and anybody who reminded me of my past, not because I hate my past, I just want to distance myself from the limitations that my past gave to me and remind myself that even now at the age of 45, I can dream about my life, I can have a vision about my life, and I can recreate or create the truest and purest version of myself. It's been hard the last 7 months because sometimes we use these defense mechanisms, the subsidizing defense mechanisms of not feeling our feelings, of numbing our feelings, of dealing in our brain with other things that are not important and not with our internal demons. In the last couple of weeks, I decided I should focus on myself. It has been helpful, stressful, sad, but helpful, the fact that two of my extended family members departed from this life. We had two losses in our extended family. Two very loving people left this earth due to cancer, and they won 2 weeks apart from the other. My encounter with death was awakening. It awakened my fear of death and my fear of living an unworthy life. And it helped me to focus on what's important in my life, what is important for my soul, on the people that are important for me, mostly myself, because I really do believe that we should focus on ourselves, and ourselves is the most important person for us on earth. And right now, that 2020 has another last two weeks for us, and then it goes finally. I feel grateful for all the invaluable lessons it has taught me. 2020 has taught me that nothing is for sure, that we are very close to mortality, that we shouldn't compromise and not sell our dreams and our visions cheaply. We should constantly remind ourselves of who we are, what is our spiritual path on this earth, what's our calling, what's the better version of ourselves, how can we live ourselves more authentically, because living an authentic life and being a better version of yourself is a sign when you say, what if I died today? Would my legacy be worthy? And yes, I really do believe that if I die today, you never know, I might die today. Any day is a possibility for us to die, because what we know for sure are two things. The first thing is that we were born, and the second is that we will die because we're human. Even if I die today, I feel that I will leave a legacy behind me worthy of living my life. I wish to all of you to have strength and stamina to learn the lessons that this hard year has taught us. Very hard year, very hard year. Every person I know on earth has had a difficult 2020. And I really do hope sincerely from the bottom of my heart that we make the best of the last 2 weeks of this year, so as to meet in 2021 with life resolutions that are focused on us, our happiness, our stability, and our internal and spiritual bliss. Love you, everybody. If you liked my video, please share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel. Every Friday, another video in English around noon is uploaded on my channel. I'm Thekla Petridou, and I wish you happy pandemic, guaranteed coronavirus holidays.